The official version of iOS 15.4 was released by Apple today with a ton of new features and changes. So let's get into the first of those new features, and that is the considerable amount of new emojis you have available to you in the emoji keyboard. We'll have some examples on display here so you can take a look, but if you do decide to update your device and check out some of these new emojis, make sure to come back to this video and leave a comment down below with your favorite new emoji in this update. Now, the next new feature is the ability to use Face ID to unlock your device even when you have a mask on. Now, when you update your device, a prompt will appear asking you if you want to use the Face ID with a mask feature versus how it's been in previous updates with your iPhone, only allowing you to enter your passcode manually when a mask was detected. Now, if you, for whatever reason, when that prompt appears, say no or decline or pass for that Face ID with a mask setting, you can actually find it in the Settings app and then go onto the Face ID and Password menu, and you'll see the Use Face ID with mask setting. Just go ahead and toggle that on. Now, also under this setting, you can set up a scan with glasses. So if you are a frequent wearer of glasses like myself, you can set up a special Face ID to recognize you with glasses on. Okay, so a huge new feature in this update is Universal Control. Universal Control allows you to essentially use your MacBook or Mac and iPad in sync. Now, not only can you use your iPad as an external display, but you can also use your Mac's trackpad and keyboard on your iPad, and you can also drag and drop files seamlessly from your Mac to the iPad and vice versa. Now, as an example, I work off my Mac Pro, but sometimes it's nice to have my iPad next to my display so I can make some quick changes to pictures and or videos using the Apple Pencil. Now, with Universal Control, it's also super easy to drag and drop those files back and forth between the Mac and the iPad. And if I wanted to quickly use my mouse and keyboard on that iPad, I actually don't have to attach that to a mouse and keyboard somewhere else and do that whole setup process. I could just seamlessly use my Mac's control features on the iPad as well. Now, another really handy feature for the iPad specifically that was added is a control center slider for keyboard brightness. So to set this up, just go into the Settings app and then go into the control center menu. And in this menu, just go ahead and add that toggle to the control center. And you can now manually control your keyboard brightness on the iPad quickly and conveniently via the control center. Now, the next new feature is for the iPhone 13 series device owners that have 120 hertz displays. There was a major bug up until now that has prevented 120 hertz from working on third-party apps. Now, in this update, iOS 15.4, that bug has now been resolved, and you can use 120 hertz animation features on all third-party devices or third-party apps that allow for that feature. Now, the next new feature is the Apple Wallet widget that has now been added to the widget feature. So to access this, go into the widget menu and then go ahead and add the Apple Wallet widget, which will allow you to get a quick glance at your Apple Wallet and more specifically your card balances should you have the Apple credit card. Now, this is a great way to stay on top of your finances and get yet another handy widget you can add to your home screen. But just be aware that this is only for the Apple Card owners out there at the time of making this video. So currently, you will not be able to glance at your Apple Cash Card balance via this new widget. So for iCloud specifically, you now have the ability to add notes to your passwords in the iCloud keychain. So this gives you the ability to perhaps add any added instructions that might need to go with any specific username and password signup, or if you have any other information, you can include that text into this new note screen. Of course, when you are done, these notes will be synced with all other devices connected to your iCloud keychain. So this process is seamless and works with all devices out there should you need to access those notes on any other devices. Now, the next new feature is more share play sharing options via the share menu. So now in the sharing menu, there will be a little share play icon and text button that appears, allowing you the opportunity to share your screen and content with others when you are on a FaceTime call. Now, this is definitely a much easier way to include content in SharePlay. And if you use that feature a lot, definitely check out the new options available in the sharing menu here in iOS 15.4. Now, next up is the new optimized battery charging feature. So if you have an Apple Watch or any sleep tracking device that connects to Apple Health specifically, optimized battery charging now bases the charging to 100% on when you typically wake up in the morning, or perhaps if you typically wake up to go to the bathroom in the middle of the night, it will intelligently recognize that and schedule the charging to resume at a later time when you actually need your device to be fully charged. So it definitely looks like things are getting to be a little bit more intuitive here with even features like small features like optimized battery charging. So Apple is continuously working on things just to improve upon what's already there here in iOS 15.4. So guys, that's most of the major new features here in iOS 15.4, but there are also some smaller ones like the tap to pay feature, which will need third-party support here. There's a new Siri voice. There's also dual sense controller support and a few others, which makes iOS 15.4 one of the biggest iOS 15 updates to date. So did you like this new iOS 15.4 update? Let me know in the comment section down below, and also let me know if we didn't cover any new features or changes that you personally found so others can go ahead and check those out as well. Anyways, guys, make sure to get subscribed to the channel for more future updates like these, and also check out our channel information link down below for giveaways and other really cool things we have going on.